Good morning, children. Here myself, Poonama Dixit Ma'am, taking science. And in today's class, children, we are going to take our annual exam revision. So, children, as you know, your annual exams are about to come. So, you need to prepare each and every topic of the chapter so that you perform your best in your annual exam. So, in today's class, children, I am going to take chapter number 11, that is force, work, and energy. And in today's class, children, we are going to cover up the first topic, that is the force. So let us see, children, what is force all about first, and then, children, we are going to know about the types of forces we have. So first, you should know what is force, and then we will know about its types. So children, let us know that, as you know that in our day-to-day life, we are always either pulling or pushing or lifting things. For this, children, if I ask you to take out a book from your bag, what you are doing? You are pulling the book out of your bag. You have to pull the book back out of the bag. Children, if I ask you to put the book back again in the bag, what are you going to do? You are going to push the book back into the bag. Then, children, if I ask you to lift the book in your hand and carry it with you, so what you are going to do? You are going to lift the book in your hand. So these are the three ways which I am sharing with you all with the help of an example of the book which you are pulling and which you are pushing and which you are lifting in your hand. So these are the ways where the force is used. So children, in all you can define force. You can say that force is defined as a pull or a push acting on an object. Push or pull is the main action which you are doing with an object. Clear, children? So you can define force as a pull or a push acting on an object, as I have shared with you about the book. Now, children, you can understand what do the force do and what all things it do in many ways. So let us try to understand. Children, force does many things to an object. First example, children, they are telling us, it can move an object. Children, what is happening? If you are throwing a ball from one place to another with the help of force applied by a hand, it is shown that you are moving an object. Whereas the ball is the object. Clear? Children, next example you can say it can change the direction of a moving object. Suppose, children, the ball is coming towards you, and when the ball is coming towards you, you are just catching the ball and throwing it in another direction. What is happening? You are changing the direction of an object. So you can say it can change the direction of a moving object, whereas the object is the ball. Children, then you can say it can stop a moving object. As when the ball was coming towards you, children, you have just catch hold of the ball and you have stopped the movement of the ball. So you can say with the help of the force, you can stop a moving object. Last point, children, it says it can change the shape of an object. As I have given you the example of the dog or clay, with the help of those examples, you can say that you can change them in any form. You can change the shape. And that is why you can say it can change the shape of an object. So these examples which we have shared with you all are being shown in your textbook. Here you can see, children, the ball is the object and the batsman is hitting the ball which was coming towards him first, and as the batsman is hitting the ball, the direction of the ball has changed. It is going to move in the other direction. So with the help of force, this can happen. Then, children, the other example being given here is about the clay. As with the help of the force being applied by your hands, you can give it any shape. Clear, children? So this shows that you can change the shape of any object with the help of force. Clear, children? These two examples are being given here in your textbook. With the help of these two examples, you can understand all these points which the force can do to an object. Children, then we talk about the types of forces. There are two types of forces in all. That the main type of forces that can act on an object all the time. One is gravitational force, and children, the other one is the frictional force. So let's talk about the gravitational force, children. or you can say it is gravity. Children, the force with which Earth pulls everything towards itself is called gravity. And we are able to stand on the ground because of this pull of the Earth. It would not be possible for the tree and the dog to stand if the Earth was not pulling them towards itself. Can you imagine, children, these actions are only possible because of the gravitational force. We are standing on the surface of the Earth. And all the other objects, if you are throwing any object above, if you are throwing, suppose, a stone, it is going to fall down on the surface of the Earth. It will never go beyond the Earth surface. As there is a gravitational force which is pulling each and every object towards itself, towards the Earth. Clear, children? So, with the help of this, you are able to understand, as it is given in your textbook, the example of a boy who is hitting a stone. And when he is hitting the stone, children, what is happening? The stone is being hit and the fruits are falling down on the surface of the Earth. And you can see the stone is also coming down and even the fruits are falling down. It is due to the gravitational force of the Earth. Next example, children, they have shown you about the astronaut who is there on the moon. And then astronaut is floating on the moon. Children, why the astronaut is floating on the moon? It is because there is no gravitational force on the moon. So that is why the astronaut is floating there. As on the Earth, it is definitely the opposite. Because there is a gravitational force there on the surface of the Earth, which is pulling each and every object, you are able to walk on the surface of the Earth. Whereas it is not possible on the surface of the moon. The astronaut is showing he is just floating on there. So in this way, children, you are able to understand what is gravitational force all about. Children, next we talk about the frictional force, or you can say friction. So let us understand, children, what is frictional or friction all about. Children, when an object moves on a surface, a force acts between the object and the surface. This force tries to stop the object and the object starts slowing down and then stops. This force is called friction. Children, if you throw a ball on the surface of any kind, what will you see? After some time, the ball will stop on its own. Clear? Why it is happening? Because of the friction. Clear? And children, if there was no friction, what would happen? Let us see. Children, this force is called friction. If there was no friction, nothing would ever stop. If there was no friction, nothing would ever stop. What will happen? Whatever we move will keep on moving. Whatever we throw or anything which we move will keep on moving. So you can understand that what importance friction has in our daily life. So you can understand, children, smoother surfaces produce less friction than rougher surface. For this example is been given in your textbook right here. Children, here there is a carom board being shown and the two kinds of carom are shown. And in one there is a powder being put and the other one is having no powder. Here you are putting the powder on the carom board and here there is no powder. So when you are playing, children, the one carom board which is having the powder, you will see that the strikers are moving very smoothly, whereas it is not able to move on the other carom board because there is no powder. And it will stop after some time. And on the other side, the powder is making the surface of the carom board very smooth. And that is why it is going to move very smooth and very fast. Clear? So in this way, children, you can understand the example of the carom board, which is a bit rough. And when you apply the powder on it, it becomes very smooth. And you enjoy the game on the carom board. So with the help of this example, children, all about the carom board, you are able to understand what is friction all about. So children, I hope with the kind of examples which I have shared with you all in this class today, you are able to understand what is force and what all things force can do Then children, the types of forces which you have learned with the help of examples, like the gravitational force or gravity, or frictional or frictional force, which I am sharing with you all with the help of examples, as they are given in your textbook also. So try to observe, children, all the things around you, and try to think why all the things are coming down towards the surface of the earth. It is because of the gravitational force. And why, children, something which you throw stops after some time? It is because of the friction. It is happening because of the frictional force, which is stopping an object. So children, that's all for the day, children. Try to observe, try to see what all things I have shared with you all in today's class, and go through the video again so that you remember each and everything what I have explained to you in my class today, and you give your best performance in your exams, and you are able to solve all the questions given in the exam. So that's all for the day, children. Have a nice day. Bye bye. Take care.